Lima, Echo, Mike, Delta, Airport Information, India, 0800, Zulu, Weather, Wind, 140, at 3, Visibility, 10,000, Sky Condition, 1,100, Scattered, Ceiling, 6,000, Broken, Temperature, 13, Dew Point, 12, QNH, 1024, Advise on Initial Contact, you have information, India. Lima, Echo, Mike.
side slope. Pull up. Wind shear. Wind shear. Wind shear. Terrain. Terrain. Pull up.
Hello.
Sink rate. Pull up. Terrain. Pull up. Don't sink. Don't sink. Too low. Terrain. Too low. Gear. Too low. Flaps. Too low. Terrain. Glide slope.
Bank angle. Bank angle.
Plus 100.
Minimums. 2,500. 1,000. 500.
Hello.
50. 40. 30. 20. 10.
Wind shear. Wind shear. Wind shear. Too low. Terrain. Caution. Terrain. 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 Pull up.
Okay, so are you ready for a departure briefing? So first we're gonna do a route check, which is Lima Echo Mike Delta, Lima Echo Papa Alpha, call sign Romeo Yankee Romeo 7 Charlie Foxtrot. The departure will be Pinar. Upper November 870 Barcelona, upper Zulu 167 Lores, and if I execute, the total distance will be 395.40 line, and we're gonna land with 3.7 and we need at least 2.6. Then instrument cross check, it's time UTC 0848, Kinect 1024, reading 2000, MFRA 3500 to confirm. Flight directors on, master on my side, and standby is.
I'm right next to her. Thank you.
Set. So it's gonna be a right-handed departure, runway 36 right, flaps 5, noise abandonment number 1. There's an emergency turn, which is straight ahead, 10 nautical miles from Barajas, VOR. Then we're gonna turn right, direct to Afin, and over Aswin, we're gonna hold there, 270 left turns, climbing to 6,000. Then the emergency briefing is above 80 knots, I will only reject the takeoff for fire. Fire warning, engine failure, predictive wind shear or aircraft unsafe or unable to fly. Before B1, if I call stop, I will simultaneously close the thrust lever and disengage the auto throttle, apply maximum brake or verify the operation of RTO, R2 brake, manually apply speed brake lever, set maximum reverse thrust and stop the aircraft. Once stopped, I will set the parking brake. And the first officer's actions are, I will not brake speed, call speed direct up or not up, reverse normal or any modifications or any abnormal indications, verify your actions are complete and call any omissions. Call 100 knots, 80 knots, 60 knots, non-runway distance remaining. Call auto brake disarm. Once the parking brake is set, I will send plus 40 and I will notify this information. And the pickup that will say, one stop will identify the failure and carry out any drills as appropriate. If we decide to evacuate, we will read and do the evacuation checklist, and if that permits, I will pull the CVRCB. And the first officer, he's the butterfly, will say, the call is keep going. If the call is keep going, before B1, there will be no actions below 400 feet, except to raise the landing gear and cancel any warnings at 400 feet. Heading select, memory edits as applicable. At the MFRA, backup, retract, flash on schedule with flaps up, no lights, level change, but see a continuous thrust on the FMC. Come on B, and glad to the MSF with the emergency procedure. Then we are on stand remote 3-5. I expect to push facing south, then Mike 5, Mike 6, all the way Mike to the north, to the holding point. Yankee 1 or Yankee 2, Yankee 3. Then we are going to do the Pinar to Romeo, runway 36 right, Pinar to Romeo is there. The blade is 30-8, 22nd Bay 19. Transition altitude is 13,000, which is there. And aerodrome elevation 1998. We're going to climb to Mach Delta 047, but there will be no turns below 400, which is there. After Mach Delta 047, we're going to turn a little bit to the right, 041, 042, close enough to Robledillo. And then after Robledillo, we're going to turn more to the right, 076, 080, close enough to Pinar. Altitude restriction, so over Mach Delta 047, 2900, Robledillo 8000, and Pinar 13000. I put myself a speed restriction of 220 for the initial turn and to get a better performance climb. And MSA, the south part is 4,500 and in the north is 10,100. Maximum speed 250 below 100, which is there. And that's it. Questions? Nope. Perfect. So, safety inspection checklist, please. Safety inspection checklist. Surface and show, check. Maintenance status, check. Battery on, electric hydraulic pumps on, landing gear lever down, ship's library check, safety inspection checklist completed, before start checklist, IRS mode selectors, NAP, gear pins, remove, light test, check, oxygen, test 100%, yaw damper on, night transfer and display switches, normal, auto, fuel, we need 6.1, we have 6.3 with 4 pumps on. Cabin utility IV galley power on. Emergency exit lights armed. Fasten belts on. Window heat on. Air condition and pressurization. Box auto. Fleets on. Set. Pressurization box selector. Auto. Instruments. Crow check. Auto brake. RTO. Hydraulics. Normal. Speed brake. Down the dam, parking brake, set. Start train cutout switches, normal. Wheel well, fire warning, check. Radios, radar and transponder, set and standby. Radar and aerodynamics, free and zero. Take off briefing, this gas, holding on the PA. Okay, the boarding is completed, so let's do the performance calculation. We have actually 180, 500, and 0 at the back. Okay, so passengers, we have 180, 20 in the front, 130 in the middle, and 330 in the back. Cargo 500. And that's it. Then we have a taxi weight of 64844, 64651, 61958.544, and we were expecting 0 fuel weight of 61. We have less than expected, but that's normal. 58.6 at the end. That give us a gross weight of 65, 64.8, close enough. Execute. Then we're gonna have a 24K, reduce 30, 24K, reduce 30. That give us a N1 of 92.3, but that's without bleed. Because if it's with the bleed on, it's gonna be gonna be 93.4, which is exactly the, what we want. Then flaps 5, CG is 21.6. That gives us a trim of 5.4. MFRA is 3570, which is set on both sides, and then 137, 139, 145, 38, 39, 145, because it must be within 2 knots. Let's close everything. Okay, so continuing with the before start checklist to the line. So PA, let's assume it's complete. FMC CDU is set. N1 at IIS back. So it's automatic 24K, reduced 30, 94.3, but it should be 93.4 once we set the APU bleed. 138, 139, 145, set. Start trim is a 5.4 unit set. Performance, weight and balance, sign and send. Fonts off, PFB, airplane mode and stow. Flight deck windows on cockpit door are locked. Doors closed. And passengers seated. So before start checklist to the line is complete. Okay, so let's request push and start. Prepare for push and start. That we have in here for 13,000. with the Pinar to Romeo and Scott will be 2000.
Hello, Captain. We're ready for pushback. Locking gear.
Okay, below the line. So, actually, first.
Locking gear.
Below the line. Air condition box off. And the collision light on. Parking brake set and transponder is out of. Before start check is below line is completed. We are ready. Okay, nose to the right.
Departure check completed. Bypass pin inserted. Release parking brakes. Commencing push. All engines clear. Start at will.
Exactly. 900. Okay, clear right. Starting engine number 2. Now have N2. Oil pressure, N1.
Set parking brakes.
Waiting your confirmation for good engine start.
Started out, monitor engine number 2, and the number 2 is stable starting. Engine number 1, clear, left. Have N2, oil pressure, and N1. Target out, monitor engine number 1. And the 1 is stable.
Locking gear. Tow truck disconnected. Bypass.
Left is clear. Right is clear.
Flight controls. Pull up. Pull down. Neutral. Pull right. Pull left. Neutral. Rudders. Pull right. Pull left. Neutral. Recall. Before touch checklist. Before touch checklist. Generators on. APU off. Start switches continuous. Broke feet on. Anti-ice off. Air condition. Packs auto. Bleeds on. Isolation valve. Auto. Flaps. 5 recorded. 5 selected. Green light. Start trim. 5.4 units required. 5.4 units set. Flight controls. Correction. Stall levers. Idle detent. Flight control. Check. Recall. Check. Before that checklist completed. Let's taxi. Let's do a configuration check. And let's go. Start trim, 5.4 unit set. Take over everything. It's gonna be Pax Auto, bleed zone. Pinar 2, Romeo departure, right hand departure seat. It's gonna be straight ahead to the right, climbing 13,000. Speeds, drive, 138, 139, 145, set. Squawk. 2000 tribute and cabin is secure. Before take a checklist to the line, complete. behind the line up Iberia, line up away. Runway 36 right behind. Yes, I do confirm. For takeoff, so landing lights on before takeoff check is completed. Timing. Stabilize, set takeoff fast. Takeoff has set, indications normal.
Have been here
for current altitude, flight level 340. Okay, so flap flap for light, set standard. Classic 7 flag, climbing 340. Pin up. After takeoff checklist. Air condition and pressurization is 3.7. Climbing and set. Gear up and off. Auto brake off. Start switches off. Altimeters. Classic 87 climbing 340. Standard is set. After takeoff checklist completed. We have been clear for 340. I'm gonna put 13,000 on a bomb. Okay, so altimeters passing 100, climbing 340, 10 checks. 10 checks to the fuel is balanced with 4 pumps, lights off. APU off. Air conditioner precision 4.2. Climbing set. We can release the crew. Brake hold and monitor 1-1 decimal flight. Touch is complete. Waiting for release of passengers. bit of throttle lines up to flight level 210, as well as under the lights. are on top. Execute. Still not available. There we go. zero just come online or not.
Flores,
as well. After Bosma, we're gonna turn right 210, 210 to 20, after 20, and right, which is there. And right, we have to be 5,000 or above. And after that, we're gonna change the other flight, which is 50-1, 13th, March 19, ILS DME. He is 10.9, which is 1, 2, set 3 times. Papa Lima Mike is the ILS ident. Final approach track 058, which is 1, 2, set 3 times. Aerodrome elevation is 27 feet. I have 50 on the panel. Transition level is by ATC and transition altitude 6000. POR and DME is required. And after and rights, 143, to intercept and follow the localizer 058. Is there, and then we're gonna pass 1900 to 1700, which is the platform that you can set there. Then at distance 5.1 from the ILS, we're gonna pick up the glide slope down to the minimums, which is 274, set twice. And in case of missed approach, I'm gonna press toggle. I will call go around, flap 15, set go around thrust. Sorry. Gear up with a positive rate at 400 feet. Alma. We will turn radius for missed approach. Return patch on schedule. Once flaps up, contact ATC, and once level, I will engage the autopilot, and we will perform the vertical check system. Then, in case of missed approach, is climb direct to Golf Oscar Alpha. Then we have to turn left maximum 185 to distance 7.5 from Juliet Oscar Alpha, radio 026, 026, distance 8. And then we will turn right, maximum 210, 2088, maximum 2000, and then after that we'll climb to 3000 and wait for ATC instructions. But I'm gonna keep it like that. So I'm gonna keep flat 5 for the initial turn and flat 1 for the other turn. Then puppies is 3 degrees, both sides. Landing distance available is 3270, wide 45 meters. Full approach landing system. And the MSA based over Golf Juliet, correction, Juliet Oscar Alpha, 5000 to the west, 3000 south, southeast, 7000 north, and 5500 northeast. Then for fuel discussion, we're gonna land with 3.2, we need at least 2.6, so that means I will have 600 extra to hold and to make decisions where to divert or to continue second or third approach, and that is about 15 minutes. Alternate is Barcelona today, and the weather is fine there as well in Mallorca. Then we're gonna burn 800. That means that we're gonna land with 61.8. Sorry, yeah. Tons with flap steady. And with flap steady at reverse operative, landing with 61.8. We can use every auto brake but moving nice. Duplicate. I am November Romeo, November 2, correction. So I'm gonna use autobrake 2, second detent on the reverse, and then move back at I am November 2, Foxtrot or Golf, Victor 2 or Victor 1, two stands from 48 through 38. Any questions or concerns? Nope. Perfect. So decent checklist, please. Pressurization, landing altitude 50, anti-ice off, approach brief and fuel discussed, IIS and outbox check and set. Descent check is completed. have been cleared to descend to flight level 200 when ready. We set 200 check. And when ready, it's gonna be there. 10-7-0, check. got 10 checks. 10 checks of fuel balance with 4 bucks. Lights on, APU off, bank 25. Air condition appreciation 4. Descending and set. Button belts on. Trickle. Deselecting 1215. I'm having crew temperatures to run 10 minutes. 10 checks complete. Next altitude, 1900. Check. correct sense, approach arm. Localizer capture, runway heading. 058. Flap right, speed check. Flap right, glide slope capture. Missed approach altitude 2000. Set. And we have been cleared to land. Cabin crew seats
2500.
Terrain noted. let's go to Foxtrot now. Master caution, electric associated. Okay, this is Victor 1. Now we go to Victor 2. Associated. APO buses. Less than 20%. and full shutdown checklist. We have fuel pumps, one for ABU, electrical on ABU, pasta belts off, window heat off, rope heat, auto, anti-ice off, electric hydraulic pumps off, packs, auto, engine bleeds on, ABU bleeds off, steering lights steady, start switches off, auto brake off, speed brake down to dead, flaps up, low lights, parking brake set, start levers cut off, weather off, transponder 2000 standby, CBR CV in, copy door, we'll unlock it now. So full shutdown checklist complete. We have external ABU off. Checklist, packs off, trimmer off, vehicle power on, emergency lights armed, ground power or APU off, and battery off. Secure checklist complete.